So this is second part we are going to start. Okay, we have done in my last video. I have just explained till I am the happy prince. Okay, till here. All right. So now let's start. Why are you? Why are you weeping then? Asked the swallow. You have quite drenched me. So here drenched means soaked with water. Okay. When I was alive, now what he's saying here? When I was alive and had a human heart, answered the statue, I did not know what tears were, for I lived in the palace where sorrow is not allowed to enter. My courtiers called me the happy prince, and happy indeed I was. So I lived and so I died, and now that I am dead, they have set me up here for high, that I can see the ugliness and all the miseries of my city. And though my heart is made of lead, yet I cannot choose but weep. What, is he not solid gold? Said the swallow to himself. He was too polite to make any personal remarks. So far away, continued the statue in a low musical voice. Far away in the little street, there is a poor house. One of the window is open, and through it I can see a woman seated at a table. Her face is thin and worn, and she has coarse red hands, all pricked by the needle, for she is a seamstress. She is embroidering flowers on a satin gown for the noblest of the queen's maids of honor to wear at the next court ball. In a bed in the corner of the room, her little boy is lying ill. He has a fever and is asking his mother to give him oranges. His mother has nothing to give him but river water. So he's crying, "Swallow, swallow, little swallow, will you not bring her the ruby out of my sword hilt? My feet are fastened to this pedestal and I can't move." So very touching line started from here, right? So the happy prince here narrating this story to the swallow. The happy prince said that when he was alive and he had a human heart. Human heart means the heart which beats is alive. At that time, he was not aware what tears were and what sorrow was, as he lived in a palace where there was happiness all around. All the people who used to work in his court used to call him Happy Prince because he used to be happy all the time, and he had not seen sorrow at all. And he said that he lived happily and died in happiness only. When he had a human heart, he never cried. He was not aware that tears were, because he had seen happiness only and never faced any sorrow. Now, when he was dead, they had put him so high in the form of statue on a pedestal that he could see the whole city and the ugliness of the city. He could see that there were so many people living misery, lack of food, hunger, money, homelessness. Now, when the statue's heart was made of lead, a metal, although it did not have any feelings, then also when it saw the sadness, it became sad and wept. So this was the story that the prince told. Okay, now I am waited for in Egypt, said the swallow. My friends are flying up and down the Nile and talking to the large lotus flower. Soon they will go to sleep. The prince asked the swallow, to stay with him for one night and be his messenger. All right. So, and his messenger, the boy is so thirsty and the mother is so sad, he said. Now here, the statue requested the swallow to stay with him for one night. He asked him to be his messenger and work on his behalf. He said that the boy was very thirsty and his mother was very sad, so it should go and give the ruby stone to her. Now, I don't think I like boys, answered the swallow. I want to go to Egypt. But the happy prince looked so sad that the little swallow was sorry. It is very cold here, he said, but he agreed to stay with him for one night and be his messenger. So the statue requested the swallow to stay with him one night. He asked him to be his messenger, okay? And on that, what the swallow said, once again the swallow opposed his request and said that it didn't like boys, so why should it help the boy? Moreover, it had to go to Egypt. But the happy prince looked so sad that the little swallow was sorry. It is very cold here. So the happy prince was so sad that swallow felt sorry for him. Okay, it said that it was very cold, so he requested him to just stay that night. The happy prince thanked him on that. Okay, and then the swallow, picked out the great ruby from the prince's sword and flew away with it in his beak over the roofs of the town. He passed by the cathedral tower where the white marble angels were sculptures. He passed by the palace and heard the sound of the dancing. A beautiful girl came out on the balcony with her lover. I hope my dress will be ready in time for the state ball, she said. I have ordered flowers to be embroidered on it, but the seamstress are so lazy. He passed over the river and saw the lanterns hanging on the masts of the ship. At last, he came to the poor woman's house and looked in. The boy was dozing feverishly on his bed and the mother had fallen asleep. He was so tired and he hoped and laid the great ruby on the table beside the woman's thimble. Then he flew gently around the bed, fanning the boy's forehead with his wings. Now cool I feel. How cool I feel, said the boy. I must be getting better. And he sank into a delicious slumber. Then the swallow flew back to the happy prince and told him what he had done. It is curious, he remarked, but I feel quite warm now, although it is so cold. That is because you have done a good action, said the prince. And the little swallow began to think and then fell asleep. Thinking always made him sleepy. When day broke, he flew down to the river and had a bath. Tonight I go to Egypt, said the swallow. So as the swallow was on its way to the poor woman's house, it passed the cathedral. So cathedral is a church, and on the church tower, white colored marble angels were sculptures. Then he reached the palace. He crossed the palace and he could hear the sound of dancing from inside the palace. When the swallow was crossing over this palace, a girl came out on the balcony along with her lover. She was hoping that the gown which she had given to the seamstress for embroidering would be ready on time. She was talking about the same gown on which that day was doing embroidering, to whom the bird had to be to give the ruby stone. When the swallow flew over the river, ships also came along the way. Lanterns were hanging on their sails. Finally, the swallow reached the woman's house. The boy was there suffering from fever, and for that reason he was not able to go to sleep. So he was turning left and right on his bed, and his mother was very tired due to working for long and had fallen asleep. Then the swallow put the ruby stone on the table near the thimble. Now here, sank means drawn, but here it means the boy is going to sleep. After keeping the ruby stone on the table, the swallow went near the boy as his mother was sleeping and no one was taking care of him. It shook its wings near him, because of which the boy could felt the cool air and felt better. The boy felt that he was getting better and went to sleep. With this we can just you know we can make out that the swallow was a very kind hearted bird. Then the swallow flew back to the prince and told him what he had done. The swallow flew back, okay, and he has just narrated the whole story. Now the bird felt warm. It says that it was very strange that it was feeling little warm in even though the weather was very cold. Now the prince said the warmth is actually just because he has done a good deed, that is why he was feeling so, right? And after listening to happy prince, the swallow started thinking about, and when he started thinking, he felt sleepy because whenever he thought, he used to sleep. Now so he visited all the monuments and sat on a long time on top of the church steeple. When the moon rose, he flew back to the happy prince. "Have you any commissions for Egypt?" he cried. "I'm just starting." "Swallow, swallow, little swallow," said the prince, "will you stay with me one night longer?" "I am waited for in Egypt," answered the swallow. "Swallow, swallow, little swallow," said the prince. "Far away across the city, I see a young man in a garret. He is leaning over a desk covered with papers, and in a glass by his side, there is a bunch of withered violets. His hair is brown and crisp, and his lips are red as a pomegranate, and he has large and dreamy eyes. He is trying to finish a play for the director of the theater, but he is too cold to write anymore. There is no fire in the grate and hunger has made him faint. I'll wait with you one night longer," said the swallow, who really had a good heart. He asked if he should take another ruby to the young playwright. "Alas, I have no ruby now," said the prince. "My eyes are all that I have left. They are made of rare sapphires, which were brought out of India 1,000 years ago. He ordered the swallow to pluck out one of them and take it to the playwright. "He will sell it to the jeweler and buy firewood and finish his play," he said. "Dear prince," said the swallow, "I can't do that," and he began to weep. "Swallow, swallow, little swallow," said the prince, "do as I command you." So the swallow plucked out the prince's eye and flew away to the young man's garret. It was easy enough to get in, as there was a hole in the roof. Through this, he darted and came into the room. The young man had his head buried in his hands, so he did not hear the flutter of the bird's wings. And when he looked up, he found the beautiful sapphire lying on the withered violets. "I'm begging to be appreciated," he cried. "This is from some great admirer. Now I can finish my play." And he looked quite happy. The next day, the swallow flew down to the harbor. He sat on the mast of a large vessel and watched the sailors walking. "I'm going to Egypt," cried the swallow, but nobody minded. And when the moon rose, he flew back to the happy prince. So children, here you can see the happy prince is telling the swallow about his second task. And he says that far away across the city, I could see a small dark room at the top of the house. A young man is sitting. He was sitting on a desk on which the papers were spread all over, and he was trying to work hard. He had a glass lying near him in which withered flowers were lying. Now, further, the happy prince said that this boy needed to finish writing a play. He was a writer, and he had to give the play to the director after writing. But he didn't have strength to write anymore because he was feeling very cold. The boy had no money, so that's why there were no fire in his fireplace. And he was very hungry, also due to which he was feeling very weak. The swallow understood what Happy Prince was trying to tell him. He knew that Happy Prince wanted to help this boy, so he agreed to stay back for one more night. And further, the swallow asked Happy Prince if he should take another ruby stone to give it to the young playwright. So the one who write play is playwright, okay, just like he had given it to the old lady. Now on this, the prince said, that it was real very sad that he did not have any more ruby stone with him. The happy prince said that now he had his eyes, which were made of very precious and rare sapphire stones, which had been brought thousands of years ago from India. So happy prince told Swallow to take out one sapphire and give it to the boy. The Swallow was very sad to learn that the happy prince wanted to give his eyes to that boy, and he started crying. He told happy prince that he could not do so now on that. But then the happy prince ordered the Swallow do whatever he asked. So finally the Swallow looked took out one eye, one sapphire out of the prince's eye, and flew to the young man's garret. There was a hole on the roof of the room, so the Swallow entered the room through that hole. The boy was sitting his head on his hands, and that's why he did not hear the flutter of the bird's wing. And when he looked up, he saw the sapphire stone lying on the flowers. So, and then when the boy saw the beautiful stone, he felt that some admirer, some person who praised him, had sent a gift for him. So he thought that with this he could now finish his play. So next morning the Swallow bird flew down to the harbor and sat on a mast of a ship. He spoke loudly that he was going to Egypt, and when it was night he flew back to the prince.